Bangladesh is known as Delta country formed by three big rivers, the Ganga, the Brahmaputra, and the Meghna. The country lies in eastern part of South Asia, surrounding by India on the west, north, and east. Some parts of east are connected with Myanmar and Bay of Bengal lies in south. One school of linguists mentioned that the word Benga is derived from Dravidian speaking tribe Bang or Banga that settled in the area around the year 1000 BEC. Another school is of the opinion that the term Banga is derived from Bodo, word Bang and La, which means white plains, whereas some other try to define it from different angles. In their opinion, the name is derived from Banga, which came from Austric word Bong, meaning the sun god. Some believe that it is derived from the Tibetan word Bans, which implies wet and moist. According to this interpretation, Bangladesh literally refers to wetland. Quite difficult to point out the exact time frame of the human settlement and historical background of Bengal due to very little recorded history of the land, language and its people. After the epic age, different rulers had come to this place from different parts of the world and ruled till separation of Indian subcontinent. Aryans, Mauryas, Sung and Gupta were the rulers of Bengal in historical period. 1500 BCE to 650 CE. In medieval age, 750 CE to 1757 CE, lots of other rulers were raised in Bengal, like Pal, Dev, Chandra, Varman, Sen, Sultan, and Mughal. After the British colonial period, 1947 CE, geopolitical territory of current Bangladesh was formed as East Pakistan. Later on, only after the Liberation War in 1971 CE, Bangladesh was established as politically independent country. Kinds of art with various media and methods have been practicing in Bengal from ancient period. Historically, Bangladesh has a strong tradition of textile and terracotta. Its geographic and climatic conditions support these creative forms. The famous Dhaka muslins were exported to the court of great Mughals during the 16th and 17th centuries. Another art of Bangladesh is painted pottery like Manasa Ghat, Lucky Sara, Sakir Hardy, and Mangal Ghat. These painted potteries are unique and dramatic with rich design elements in original motifs, forms and patterns with bright and lively colors with glorious remote tradition. Alpana, floor decoration and art, pot painting. Painting a kula, a semi-oval shaped tray made out of bamboo. Body decoration and art, mehendi, alta, haldi tradition, etc. are the folk paintings and folk tradition of Bangladesh. We can define the partition of Indian subcontinent as turning point of modern art as well as popular art of Bangladesh. Similarly, to other developing countries, decorative transport is a common phenomenon to modern Bangladesh. Rickshaw art remain unique in perhaps one aspect, in that they sometimes either directly or indirectly depict social and political themes, as well as subjects from folk tradition, religious mythology, fantasy, landscapes, realistic paintings of monuments, events of national, international importance, and so on. The word rickshaw derives from the Japanese word jin rikisha, which means man-powered vehicle. The term jinrikisha was first used for the hand-pulled two-wheeler vehicle, which was running as a mode of popular transport in Asian cities in the 1920s and 1930s. After the Second World War, rickshaw significantly used as an alternative vehicle by general people, which made an economical balance in Japan. Though rickshaw was discovered in Japan, different people from different countries have contributed behind this invention. When and who is the inventor of rickshaw is not clear. People have different opinion about it. Japanese source mentions that Izumi Yosuke, Suzuki Tokujiro, and Takayama first made rickshaw in 1868. They became more popular when the Emperor Meiji used one of a series of ships around the capital. By 1880, there were at least 1,60,000 rickshaws, and they were started to appear in Shanghai, Singapore, Hong Kong, and other Asian cities. It is believed that the modern rickshaw had reached Chittagong from Myanmar in 1919. But Mr. Gallagher wrote in his book, The Rickshaws of Bangladesh, that the first rickshaw in Bangladesh appeared in 1930s. Many man-powered vehicles were developed in different centuries in several places. Palanquins, 1883. Tricycle. Deluxe Royal. Pedicab, 1690. Phone Checker, 1870. Handpulled Rickshaw, Cape Town, 1919. Handpulled Rickshaw, Singapore, 1947. Coolie Cycle. Though rickshaw was introduced in Bangladesh in 1919, it was not until the 1950s that different colorful artworks were added to it. It became popular and common transport vehicles in Bangladesh, both in urban and rural areas. Nowadays, when rickshaw moves from one place to another, it moves not only with the passenger and load, but it moves with a museum of art. Every inch of rickshaw is well covered with paintings, tassels, tinsels, and colorful plastics and college work. Some decorative parts of rickshaw. Dib or chosma, wooden box placed under the passenger seat. Gold boat, round object, sometimes in different shapes, fixed on back mudguard. Pichuni tana, thick and long iron flat rod used to support or hold two back wheels. Samune tana or magari stick, flat iron rod used to hold front mudguard and attached with front wheel, fork and front fork. Thallur or thallot, freely hung plastic cutting and plastic patterns. Hood tana, two back parts of hood fixed on back body with the help of board pin. Kheroni, a design made with colorful plastic cuttings which you used to keep on front part of handle in semicircle position. Panja, hood bracket. Kabja, hood latches. Kamani, hood bamboo. Passenger seat. Dhelna, back support of passenger seat. Orna, parda or jhallori, sari covered fixed on top side of front hood as a decoration and sometimes to cover the passenger. Padani, footboard. Kolos, brass pot or steel cuff fixed on front mudguard or in front of handle. Tana Latkuni, object hung on back tana like pendulum. Pichuni Parda, freely hung rigzine piece in between two hood tana. Cap, tin sheet used on top of front hood like cap. From the very beginning, artists painted flowers and village scenes. Hindu painters represented goddesses such as Kali, Durga and story of Ramayana and Mahabharata, etc. Muslim painters introduced Borak, Mosque and Dargahs. The time period between 60s and 70s is also known as golden period of Riksha art of Bangladesh. This was the period when Riksha art began to diversify and accommodate itself even more to popular tastes. During this period, movie scenes and actors were added to Riksha art as these were two popular subjects for the people. This art was inspired by the contemporary Bangladesh, Indian and Pakistani movie and actors. Still in Rajshahi district of Bangladesh, we can see lots of influence of contemporary Indian movies and Indian actors in Riksha art. The representation of romantic scenes is very dramatic in Riksha paintings. Along with rural landscapes, cityscapes got place in back plates of Riksha and soon this became more and more fantastic. This is a time when social and political contents were added to Riksha painting. During this decade, Bangladeshi had started the language movement as they were ever proud of their linguistic and cultural identity. Some liberation war scenes appeared in Riksha paintings for a short time during that year, such as torture, killing, enemies and freedom fighters, scenes of tanks being destroyed and fighter planes sweeping across the sky. The Pakistani army's atrocities against women are very common subject of that period. According to Riksha painter Ahmad Hussein, around 1972 that in country, foreigners were taking a huge interest in atrocity image by purchasing panels in the market. So the government had requested artists and makers to stop this scene. This is a time when the Riksha artists started to print scenes of animals with the human behaviors. Also, the historical architectures and famous landscapes got important place in Riksha paintings. One Riksha hood maker, Muhammad Salim of Dhaka, told that the pattern cutting for Riksha art is influenced by Chalut cutting tradition of Bangladesh. According to him, Chalut design was started from 40s, whereas collage art on hood was started from 60s only. After 2000, lots of experiments have been done in Riksha art. Though big mega cities had lost the identities of world famous Riksha art, it is very surprising that small town like Vaidok has still managed to preserve this art with success. Capital city of Bangladesh, Dhaka is the origin of the world famous Riksha art. Still we can see all kinds of development and experiments which has been done in different time period in Riksha art Dhaka. Riksha painting of Feni is very different from other parts of Bangladesh. It looks like a fog painting. Green color is appeared as main dominating color in the Riksha art of Feni. Peacock is used as a common subject in all Riksha paintings, which represents the fog form. Totally different and unique Riksha artworks have done in Khulna. Board paintings of this place is also quite different as like nave art. Woods are painted with different patterns. The important parts of Riksha art of Khulna are footboard and dib. These parts are covered with different artworks. Here we can see different shapes and patterns made with brass sheets and aluminum fixed on footboard and dib with board paint arrangement. Subjects of Riksha paintings of Mymensingh are also different from other places as geometrical shapes and its arrangement dominates in works. Nowadays, lots of contemporary artists are working in Riksha theme and some of them are working in collaboration with Riksha artists. Though Riksha art of Bangladesh has been facing lots of problems from the beginning, it became very famous in the world. It helps to spread the information of Bangladeshi art and culture. This art has always representing the pure independent feelings of common people of Bangladesh as well as Bangladeshi culture. In the art, we can also find the conscious, subconscious and unconscious stage mind of artists. In painting, artists are expressing the desire and dream of life, as like in primitive art and folk art.